Hello and good morning, dear students. Today we are starting our another class of chapter metals and non-metals. In our last class we have discussed the reaction of metals and non-metals with acids and bases, and in today's class we will discuss the displacement reaction in metals. Displacement reaction takes place where there is strong and weak metals takes place in the chemical equation. As displacement reaction, it gives better evidence about reactivity of metals. Means displacement reaction tells us the reactivity series of metals. Means it tells us from two metals which metal is strong and which one is weak. A more reactive metal can replace a less reactive metal. Means if we are doing an equation or any chemical reaction between two metals, then we will have to find out the which one is more reactive and the another one is less reactive. To understand displacement reaction, we take the help of an activity. As we take five beakers named beaker A, beaker B, C, D and E, and in each beaker we take two different metals. As in beaker A, we take a solution of copper sulfate CuSO4 and we pour some zinc metal in it, and we notice that ZnSO4 means zinc sulfate forms and copper metal will move out. As the reaction in the beaker A, CuSO4 makes a green color solution or a light blue color solution. So when zinc granules are added in copper sulfate solutions, we observe that after some time the blue color of the copper sulfate solution disappears, and this disappearance of blue color tells us that zinc is more reactive than copper, because zinc taken place of copper and displaced the copper from the solution. In the same way, in beaker B, copper sulfate solution, blue color solution is present, and when we add Fe means iron granules, then we see that in the same way the reaction taken place in beaker A, the same reaction takes place in beaker B also. In beaker B again, the blue color solution changes into light green color, which tells us that FeSO4 is formed and copper is displaced. Means Fe taken place of copper in the sulfate solution. So from both these reactions in beaker A and beaker B, we get an idea that zinc is more reactive than copper. In the same way, Fe means iron is more reactive than copper, because zinc replaced copper sulfate solution with copper. Means zinc has taken the place of copper because it is more reactive than copper. In the same way, in beaker B, Fe means iron replaced copper. As Fe taken place of copper in the sulfate solution and made FeSO4, and copper is removed. And in the same way we do the reactions in the beaker C, D and E. In beaker C, we take zinc sulfate solution ZnSO4 and we add copper granules, and after some time we observe that there is no color change. It is because there is no color change we get a result that no reaction takes place. Means no reaction takes place because copper is less reactive than zinc. In the same way, in beaker D and beaker E, FeSO4 solution copper is added. Again we observe that after some time no reaction takes place, means no color change in FeSO4 solution, because iron is more reactive than copper. In beaker is ZnSO4 plus Fe, it again tells that no reaction takes place because zinc is more reactive than iron. So from these five chemical equations, we get an idea of reactivity of metals. As we observed that in first and second, zinc replaced copper, iron replaced copper. It means zinc and iron both are more reactive than copper. Means in reactivity series, zinc and iron are more reactive than copper metal. But from the beaker C, D and E, from these three equations, we get a result that copper is not available to replace the zinc. Copper not replace the Fe, means copper not replace the iron. In the same way, iron cannot replace the zinc. By these five chemical equations, we get a reactivity series for these three metals. So reactivity series for these metals is as follows: zinc, Fe and copper. Zinc replaced copper, iron replaced copper. It means zinc and iron both are more reactive than copper. Means zinc is reactive than iron, iron is reactive than copper. So reactivity series of some metals is as follows and is in the order of decreasing order from left to right. Means on the left side, K potassium, Na sodium, Ca calcium, magnesium Mg, aluminium, zinc, Fe, Pb, H, copper, Hg, Au and Pt. It is the decreasing order of reactivity series, means metals on the left side are more reactive than the right one. So from this reactivity series, we come to know the reactivity of metals, as K means potassium, Na means sodium. So potassium and sodium are most reactive metals. That's why potassium and sodium are stored in kerosene. And on the other hand, the least reactive metals, copper, Hg means mercury, Au means gold, and Pt means platinum. So platinum is the least reactive metal and potassium is the most reactive, means highest reactive metal. Being gold and platinum the least reactive, gold is used for making jewelry because it is least reactive metal, so it cannot react with the atmospheric gases, means it do not react with atmosphere, water, moisture, humidity. But there may be one more question, that why we don't use platinum for making jewelry, because platinum is least reactive but gold is little bit reactive than platinum. The reason is that platinum is very costly, that's why platinum is not used for making jewelry. And gold is little bit more cheaper than platinum, that's why gold is used for making jewelry. So it's all about displacement reaction. The next is uses of metals and non-metals. There are many uses of metals and non-metals. We will discuss some important uses. The first one, metal use, is zinc metal is used for galvanizing iron to make it anti-corrosion material. Means if a layer of zinc is applied on iron, it will not react with the atmospheric gases. It will be protected from corrosion. Means galvanization, a zinc layer is applied on iron to make anti-corrosion material. The next is iron used as construction material in bridges, houses, ships, etc. The next use of iron is iron mixed with nickel and chromium for making stainless steel. And we use stainless steel to make utensils for our household items. The next use of metal is lead is used for making water pipes and batteries. The next is mercury is also a metal which is liquid at room temperature, is used in thermometers. The next metal, copper, is used for electric wires. The next use of metal is radioactive metals like uranium and plutonium are used in nuclear power plants. So uranium and plutonium are used in power plants for the production of electricity. Now next we are discussing the uses of non-metals. The first use is sulfur is used for making sulfuric acid and matchbox. The next of boron is in the form of borax is used as skin ointment. The next non-metal use, phosphorus, is used in making crackers. Oxygen is used for respiration processes. Chlorine in the form of bleaching powder is used to purify water. Iodine is used to prevent thyroid problems and as an antiseptic. We are using common salt at our houses. It is rich source of iodine, which enables the proper functioning of our thyroid gland and prevent us from thyroid problems. The next non-metal is nitrogen is used for making fertilizers. So it's all about our uses of metals and non-metals. There are some practice questions for your practice. Four fill-ups are there. The first one is dash metal is used for galvanization. The next question is dash property of metal produces ringing sound. The next fill-up is dash is a non-metal that shows luster. The next fill-up is dash metal is best conductor of electricity. And the last question is describe five uses of each of metals and non-metals. It's all about our today's class. Hope you all understood. Have a great day. Meet you soon in our next class.